This is a great crowd. This is Jacqueline Swift's second workshop here. I think we get a great crowd for her. We're really lucky to have her. Before we get started, just a couple of quick announcements. All the information was right on this little cart in the back, so if you get a chance to pick it up, you can grab it whenever. There's a couple of information sheets from Jacqueline there. And there's also a survey. You can just fill that out before you go. It helps us improve the program and get some feedback. That would be great. I'm Sarah, by the way. I saw a few faces. I don't know if you heard from if you got a phone call or something for her article. Also, we have a Gleaning Project fundraiser going on. The Gleaning Project is what the Cooking Nutrition Program is a part of here at CCRM. The basic idea of the Gleaning Project is using that which would have otherwise gone to waste. Mostly we're coordinating with local farmers to collect their leftover harvest to make sure it's distributed to all the community who need it. We also do some community garden programming and school garden and education as well as this cooking nutrition program. If you're interested in purchasing a little packet of cards, we were emailing to them, and there's homemade envelopes in here as well. The suggested donation is $6, so you can see me afterwards if you're interested. And what else? We've also really excited that we've begun filming the cooking nutrition workshops here. Our intention is to be able to either put them on the website, and hopefully also put them on a disc so we can share the disc with other agencies like pantries so that they can share them with their clients who can't make it here to see these great classes. So while we're filming, if you could try to keep chatting to a minimum. If you have like a comment, just raise your hand and you can make sure it's included in the filming so everyone knows what the question was or what your comment is. That'd be great. So you all have a strange green concoction on your table, and that is pesto. It's made with Jacqueline's homegrown garlic, naturally grown garlic, which you will all be taking home. I think we have enough for everyone to take two bulbs, so make sure you don't leave without your two bulbs of garlic. I didn't include a recipe for the pesto because, honestly, I would encourage you to just use what you have and taste as you go. The ingredients that I used for this pesto were garlic, fresh basil, fresh virgin olive oil, grated Parmesan cheese, just like the shaky cheese, and walnuts I use. But you can use any variety of herbs you want. I have really great cilantro pesto, oregano pesto. You can use all kinds of different nuts. Pine nuts is pretty typical. I use walnuts because it's cheap. You can get them pretty cheap at the top of the bulk section. You can try different cheeses, different oils, whatever you want. And I just taste, I taste as I go. I think I went through probably 6 or 8 spoons today. Taste put in the sink because that's how I have to make this stuff. So definitely experiment. It's one of my favorite things to make and it's so easy. Also on your way out, there will be a big crate of produce from Gong Garden, which is a local CSA in Fredonia. It's all organic, we raise produce. And we have a big crate to share with everyone today. So maybe just take one or two items. If there's leftover, take more. So without further ado, I just want to share a little info about Jacqueline before we get started. Jacqueline Swift is an herbalist, nutritionist, and co-owner of Rainbow's End Herb Farm in Perrysburg. Her love of nature and herbs began as a child in southern Indiana with farming grandparents who gathered wild foods in the Ridge Country along the Ohio River. In the early 70s, Jacqueline began studying medicinal aspects of herbs and later took courses in botany and nutrition at Buff State, graduating with a BS in dietetics. Her other teaching experience includes 4 years as an instructor at the Lexington Food Co-op. Workshops and talks have been provided for the Buffalo and Erie County Botanical Gardens, New York State Direct Marketing Association, Migrant Tutorial Program in Fredonia, the Hopeville School, Senior Citizens, Local Herb Organization, the Fredonia Farmers Market, etc. Since 1978, Jacqueline has operated a business specializing in culinary and medicinal herbs. The family-owned organic farm features an 1840s farmhouse shop, production and display gardens, and barn animals. Fine herb products are made on the farm and sold wholesale, retail, and by mail order. Luncheon and tea tours, classes, and special events are featured throughout the May through December season. I just had my first visit a few weeks ago, and it's definitely worth it. So thank you very much, Jacqueline, for being here.
Thank you, Sarah, and thank you, everyone, for coming out on this gorgeous Western New York day. It's really a pleasure to be here. Our focus today is on the herbal medicine chest. So we're going to be talking about first aid with herbs and acute and preventive medicine with herbs. Now, I do want to make sure everyone has the handouts. Does everyone have the free pages for handouts? Are they over there?
We don't. Okay.
But that's very important information for you. Also, I'm going to pass around three baskets. While I talk, you can look through here. First of all, I have some products, some simple remedies, the way herbs are used. And these are two ointments we made. You can open those right up, try them on. We want to get a lot of senses going today. So I have a basket of very fragrant herbs that I just gathered this morning from the garden. So we're just going to start these around, and everybody can take a look at what's coming around. So make sure you get a look into the three different baskets. And most of these herbs we're going to be discussing. Some of them I threw in some extras for interest. So, okay, so they pass it to there. Yeah, make sure everybody's covered.
Mm-hmm. How exciting.
Now, before I start, I would like to hear from you. A lot of times, folks have favorite home remedies. So if you can raise your hands, we'll hear from you and tell me about one of your favorite home remedies that works, that really works. Anybody got a favorite
one?
Elderberry juice
for colds and flu in winter.
Everybody here?
Elderberry juice for colds and flu in winter.
That's a great one. Yeah, it helps the genes all the time. Anybody else?
Aloe vera gel for burns.
Excellent, yeah. That's even used in burn hospitals.
Wow.
It's loaded with vitamin E. And how do you keep it around?
I take it from the plant.
How do you do it, Carmen?
And then I squeeze the leaf and put the oozing ointment right on the burn. And I can't instant. I got burned enough, but I didn't have time to do it.
Excellent. So she keeps a nice, healthy plant, cuts off a leaf, and puts it right on the burn. You can bandage them on there. I like to cut a leaf of that in the summertime, keep it in the fridge. If you get a sunburn, it just feels so good.
Oh, nice.
If you can't keep the plant, you can actually buy tubes of aloe vera gel. And that's, you can keep that in the fridge and put that on a sunburn. Excellent. It's loaded with vitamin E. It's great. A friend of mine used to like to work on her car. She grabbed a hot muffler, burnt her hand, but totally healed it with aloe. No scars left behind. Yeah, so that's a really good one to come around. Anybody else got a favorite remedy?
Also, if you just put rashes in it.
Rashes, yeah, itches. Yeah. Anybody else got a favorite?
I for the very first time had an experience playing through this on infected wounds. And there are people that open the wounds and the shooting.
Open wounds that were bleeding.
Yeah.
And I put on her leg.
Leg. It lay right there. So okay. I had a slight nail. It stopped the bleeding. And after the wound had broken, it healed up and left no scar.
Yeah. So we're going to be talking more about play. That's one thing we keep at home, and I love that. Yeah, play. So play. Yeah.
What is that? What is that?
Play. What is it?
Oh, play. Like dirt kind of play.
Yeah, like dirt kind of play. Okay. Yeah. We're talking more about that later. Right now, I want to survey you guys for what works for you at home. Anybody else? Nope. Well. Thank you very much. One of the remedies my